Hey guys, Pastor Greg Locke here. Have you noticed how the new atheism has become so antagonistic?
If you want to discuss antagonism, what about Christianity? Christians make up nearly 80% of the country we live in, and even more so in the southern states. 8 different states have banned atheists from running for government office. It's in their state constitution. Atheists don't get to put slogans in schools or courthouses or car tags or money. We don't get to ban Christians from running for office. And from personal observation and experience, I can tell you that I've never seen a more antagonizing or aggressive group of people than Christians, or violent, or racist, or promiscuous. And you guys have the ability to freely go about your life, publicly displaying and discussing your beliefs without fear of being shunned from your entire group of friends, or losing the respect of someone you admire, or missing out on the love of your life because of your beliefs. But meanwhile, you Christians, the largest group of people in the entire world, by the way, cry about being persecuted and antagonized while you bully everyone else. Most of the atheists I know haven't even come out of the closet yet because they're scared of being thrown out of their house or dumped by their girlfriend or excommunicated from their entire social circle. Most of the atheists I know still go to church out of fear. If the tables were turned, you'd be wishing that the only antagonism you had to face was criticism on the internet. You Christians, especially in America, have it better than any other group of people in the entire world. Who's the antagonist, Greg?
We hate a God that we don't even believe in. If you can't explain God, we're not going to believe in him.
I don't hate God, or Yahweh, in this case. I've never said that, ever, in my life, and neither has any other atheist I've ever known or heard speak. Please provide me one single clip of an atheist saying that they hate God. You won't find it. You're creating a straw man, Greg. No atheist hates God or gods. I don't hate Vishnu, or Apollo, or Allah, or the Tao, or Ahura Mazda. I don't hate ghosts either. Do you have some burning hatred for Bigfoot, or do you just not believe in him?
If you can't explain God, we're not going to believe in him. Listen, if I could explain God in a way that your 3-pound brain could contain it, then he wouldn't be worthy of your worship anyhow.
It's not necessary for you to fully explain him, but it is necessary to prove that he's real. But you're completely avoiding this burden of proof by misrepresenting the argument, and then saying Yahweh is too complex for you to even understand, like Batman versus Superman.
And pray tell me, why is it that every time something bad happens, they blame it on a God that they don't even believe in? And look, you really can't have it both ways. Just because there's storms and starvation and rape and murder does not mean that there's not a God.
No atheist has ever blamed Yahweh for natural disasters or any other catastrophe. That's a paradox. It's a contradiction. It's like a married bachelor. An atheist, by definition, doesn't believe in God and therefore wouldn't believe that he was responsible for catastrophes. If someone believed God was responsible for the deaths of everyone who dies of cancer, then they're not an atheist, they're an angry Christian. So no atheist has ever done that. It's like a married bachelor. It's a contradiction. It can't exist.
Just because there's junk and garbage going on in the world doesn't mean there's not a God. God made everything perfect. He gave us the keys to the car, and we're the ones that put it in the ditch.
You're absolutely right. Storms and wars and disease aren't evidence that there is no God, but it is evidence that it's not the one you Christians believe in. Either that, or he really needs to get his priorities straight. If you claimed that your God doesn't intervene with us, or that he has handed us the keys of our car and stepped away, then atheists and myself wouldn't bring global catastrophes up as an argument for Christians. However, you do believe that Yahweh saves people and answers prayers, so you do believe in miracles, and you do believe that God God has his hands in our lives. So guess what, Greg?
You really can't have it both ways.
Either God answers prayers or he doesn't. Either he cures some people of cancer and not others, or he doesn't do any of it. Either he saves one family from a tsunami and allows the others to drown, or he didn't do any of it.
You really can't have it both ways.
Either he blessed you with a cheeseburger and ice cream while letting 840 million people starve, or he doesn't get involved with human matters. Which is it, Greg? You can't have it both ways. Either God helps some people and doesn't help others, or he doesn't do anything. You pick.
You really can't have it both ways.
If you can admit that Yahweh has never done anything in your life or anyone's lives, then I won't point out that he cares more about upper-class white Americans than collectively everyone living in Haiti.
How many atheists do you know that want to fuss and fight with you about trolls and about Smurfs and about fairies? None of them. They all want to fight about God. Why? Because you don't fight stuff that's non-existent. You fight stuff that in your conscience you know is existing.
If believers in trolls wanted to indoctrinate me and my children, then yeah, I would have something to say about that. If 80% of the country I lived in were Smurfians worshiping Papa Smurf, then I would try to educate them. If people were bullied and threatened and shunned for not believing in fairies, then I would do exactly what I'm doing now. I'm not fighting Yahweh or you, Greg. I'm fighting an oppressive ideology that has hurt a lot of people, including myself and people I care about. Also, your logic is extremely flawed. People only argue against things that they believe in? Really? By your own standard, you must know deep down in your heart that evolution is true, because you've argued against it. Kent Hovind and Ken Ham must be the biggest believers of evolution out there. They've dedicated their lives to fighting against it. Your logic doesn't hold up. Any of it. Atheists don't believe in any of the religions. So are you going to assert that we simultaneously believe in all of them just because we fight against them? And atheists who argue against Ouija boards and astrology and psychics, do they believe in them too? We fight against ideas that we see to be wrong or harmful. Christianity just so happens to be one of the most prominent threats in the United States. So yes, it's more often targeted than Zoroastrianism or Jainism, but trust me, I'm strongly against Islam and Judaism as well, and I don't believe in their dogmas or deities either.
I'm here to tell you, you have no morality except for the God code that has been placed within you. You have no morality except for the God code that has been placed within you.
I'll make a separate video about morality. I don't have the time to delve into it here, but I'll get to it later. But if my morality was given to me by some deity, it wasn't your Yahweh. I can't stress enough how much I highly disagree with the ethics that the character Yahweh stood for in the Bible stories. They're completely detestable, almost all of them. If I were to look at all the religions and see which one most aligns with my moral code, as if that were some indication of its legitimacy, then I would have to conclude Taoism to be the one true religion, as its moral framework is exceptional, and certainly one that we humans could potentially live by without stoning anyone or cutting off our genitals or treating women as inferior beings. My moral code and most Christians' moral codes are light years away from the ethics instructed in the Christian Bible. Even the most uneducated and unpleasant people have a higher standard of morality than Yahweh. Genocide isn't okay. Misogyny is wrong. Cutting kids' junk off is disgusting and just completely evil. And if the Bible is the apotheosis of our morality, why did it fail to condemn slavery, or pedophilia, or animal cruelty, or polygamy? Our morals don't come from Yahweh. Human ethics have progressed a lot in the last few thousand years without the assistance of deities. We believe in equality now. We have democracy and freedom and human rights and traffic laws. They didn't come from Yahweh.
Every man is born with the light of Christ. Every man is born with the light of Christ.
Well, that's definitely not true. Nobody is born believing in Jesus or with some existential urge to worship up a Jewish rabbi. If you're born in a Christian family, you'll probably believe in Christ by the age of 7 or so. If you're born in a Hindu family, you'll have the same experience with Krishna. Or in an Islamic family, it'll be Muhammad. Kids born in Africa don't suddenly start eating crackers and drinking Welch's grape juice after taking a dunk in the river. You have to be brainwashed into this nonsense. It's not innate.
So at the end of the day, you can say you don't believe in God, but the truth is, God doesn't believe in atheists.
At the end of the day, you can say that you don't believe in ghosts, but the truth is, ghosts don't believe in you. Is that a good argument? No, it's not. It's terrible.
The heart of the issue is not that you deny deity, it's that you deny responsibility, because you don't want any accountability.
No, I don't, and neither do any atheists I personally know or have ever heard of. Humans hold each other accountable, and we personally hold ourselves accountable as well. That's how the world works. If I mess up, it's not Satan or demons, it's me. I'm responsible for what I do, and when we mess up, we have to live with the consequences. If I hurt someone in some way, I have to earn their forgiveness, not say a quick prayer and everything is better. If you screw up, you can't just say, hey, Jesus forgives me. No, you have to live in the real world and with the reality of the things you've done and the people you've hurt. Every meth head I've ever known is a Christian, and not just like sort of a Christian, they're all uber Christians. All they talk about is Jesus and how he died for their sins. The Christian concept of forgiveness takes away all accountability.
We're all just messed up people and he died for us. He died for our sins. We've all got our demons, you know?
No, absolutely not. Nobody is dying for my mistakes. If I mess up, it's my responsibility to make it right, not some Jewish guy 2,000 years ago, or anyone. And when I mess up, it wasn't a demon either, or the enemy. We are all accountable for ourselves. It's our obligation to the people we love and the world we live in. We don't have to love a magic Jew in the sky who's threatening us with eternal hellfire in order to not hurt people. We don't hurt people because we love them, or at least we love humans, or we love the world we live in. I love people for the sake of loving them, not because a first century mythical messiah told me to. I don't have to be told to, and neither do you. I care about the people in my life because they're beautiful and amazing and deserving of love. I care about the world and leaving it a better place after I'm gone because billions and billions of fantastic and incredible and intelligent people who won't even know I ever existed are going to live in it after I'm gone, and they deserve the best. And that's what holds me accountable, my extended family of humans, my descendants, the other life forms that share this planet, and everyone else that I get to experience this crazy and terrible and terrific journey we call life with. And life is a whole lot better when you're loved by others, and there's no better way to be loved than to love everyone else genuinely and selflessly.
But I'm here to tell you, you're going to stand before God, and every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. You can deny the reality of hell, but that won't make it one degree cooler when you get there.
Well, I'm here to tell you that one day you're going to stand before Allah, and as it says in chapter 3 and verse 85 of the Quran, he that chooses a religion over Islam, it will not be accepted, and in the world to come, he will be one of the lost. And whenever you try to escape from hell, you will be dragged back and told, taste the torment of the conflagration. Denying the existence of Allah and the prophecies of Muhammad won't make hell one degree cooler. Are you scared, Pastor Greg? No, me neither. It's just a book written by ancient desert-dwelling psychopaths who wanted to control the ignorant masses with unfalsifiable threats and promises of golden palaces and virgins in the afterlife.
So at the end of the day, God's gonna get his glory with or without you.
Every argument Greg makes is completely interchangeable with Islam or Hinduism or any religion. This is the ultimate indicator of a worthless argument. If your argument serves just as effectively and efficiently for a Jew or Rastafarian or Zoroastrian, Taoist, Catholic, or pagan, then your argument is literally pointless. It's cheap rhetoric. It won't convince anyone, but it sure as as hell sells to the choir that you're preaching to, which is why Greg has made the same exact video 3 times. Get paid, get laid, Gatorade.